Solana is fast, really fast. We're talking over 2,600 transactions per second, and fees so low you could sneeze and miss them, about $0.00025 a pop. Some people call it the Ethereum killer. But is it really the next Ethereum? Let's rewind a bit. Ethereum was the first big smart contract platform. Launched in 2015, it became the backbone for DeFi, NFTs, and thousands of blockchain apps. But let's be honest, it's got problems. When things get busy, fees can skyrocket to $20 or more for a single transaction. And it only handles about 15 transactions per second. Now, here comes Solana, bursting onto the scene in 2020. It's blazing fast with fees under a penny. Where an Ethereum token swap might cost you $50, on Solana, it's basically pocket change. But hold up, speed isn't everything. Ethereum's got a massive validator network, over a million strong. That's a ton of decentralization and security. Solana, around 1,300 validators. Not bad, but definitely more centralized. And that could mean more risk when it comes to security or censorship. Here's a big one, network reliability. Solana's had its share of outages, times when the whole thing just stopped. Not great when you've got billions of dollars moving around. Ethereum never had a total network failure. That reliability really matters. So, what's each chain actually good for? Ethereum absolutely dominates DeFi. Most of the biggest protocols, Uniswap, Aave, you name it, they live on Ethereum. It's also the home of major NFT collections. And with Layer 2s like Arbitrum and Polygon, it's getting faster and cheaper. Solana's carving out its own niche. It's booming in gaming, payments, and consumer apps. Those ultra-low fees mean microtransactions actually make sense. You can build things where users don't even notice the cost of using the blockchain. Then there's the developer side. Ethereum uses Solidity, a language loads of developers already know. Solana uses Rust, powerful but trickier to pick up. That changes how quickly new projects can get off the ground. Market cap time. Ethereum is a giant, over $300 billion and billions in daily trading. Solana's smaller but growing fast, maybe more room to run? So is Solana the new Ethereum? Not exactly. They're evolving in different directions. Ethereum's becoming the secure, decentralized base for big complex stuff. Solana's the go-to for fast, cheap apps and games. They both have a place in crypto's future. Ethereum is too established and secure to disappear. But Solana's building something genuinely new, and it's worth keeping an eye on. Join us and reach your next crypto level.